Let's start with a quarter circle, and then from its upper right corner, let's construct a random half circle. Now from the intersection point between this half circle and our big quarter circle, we will construct another quarter circle so that its center is the same as the center of this bigger quarter circle. If the length of the bottom horizontal line is equal to 4, is it possible for us to find this red shaded area? If you want to answer this question for yourself, you can pause the video right now and try this problem out, and then come back to see the solution. Alright, let's get to the solution. So, for this problem, I will offer you three different methods. The first method will be the normal way to solve this problem. In this method, we will first mark all given points. We will mark A and B as the points of intersection between the half circle and the quarter circle, and O will be the center of these two quarter circles. Let's also mark the point C that will represent the center of our half circle. Now, let's draw a radius of this half circle and mark it as R. Now, you can clearly see that the line AC and the line CB will also have the length of R. Now let's set the radius of our smaller quarter circle as big letter R. That means that the radius of our bigger quarter circle must have the length of 4 minus R. As before, we can rotate this radius of the smaller quarter circle and we will get that the line OA is also equal to the value of big R, and if we do this for our bigger quarter circle, we can see that the line OB has the length of 4 minus R. Now we can use the equality of the lengths of these lines in order to form our equation. You can clearly see that the combined length of the lines OA, AC and CB must be equal to the length of the line OB. So we can form the equation. We can say that small r plus big R must be equal to 4 minus R. Now we can simplify this equation to get to the following. From here we will put big R on the right side of the equation, and we will get the following equation of 2 small r that is equal to 4 minus 2 big R. Of course, we can divide everything with 2, and we will get that the radius of our small half circle must be equal to 2 minus big R. Alright, now let's mark all our circular segments as A1, A2 and A3. That means that the overall red shaded area must be equal to the sum of the areas of both quarter circles minus the area of this half circle. Now let's start with the area of our smallest quarter circle. It would be equal to 1/4 of the big R squared pi. We can rewrite this as following. Now let's set our attention to this big quarter circle. It would be equal to 1/4 of the quantity of 4 minus big R squared pi. We can develop this equation by using the square of binomial. Just to remind you guys, the formula for square of binomial states that quantity of a minus b squared must be equal to a squared minus 2ab plus b squared. So we can use this equation and we will get that area 2 must be equal to the quantity of 16 minus 8r plus r squared pi over 4. Now let's go to the area number 3, this half circle. Its area must be equal to the 1/2 of the r squared pi, and since we already got the value for the radius of this small half circle, we are going to substitute that value in and get the following. Now, of course, we can develop this further by using the same formula for square of binomial. And by using this formula, we are going to get that area 3 must be equal to the quantity of 4 minus 4r plus r squared pi over 2. Now we can take all these values that we got and put them in our first equation. And we will form the following expression. Now let's try to simplify this expression a little bit. We're going to leave the first term, then for the second term we're going to divide everything with 4 and multiply with pi to get the following. We are going to do exactly the same thing for our third term, only this time we are going to divide everything with 2 and multiply with pi. Now let's simplify things a little bit. Let's first take a look at the first and the fourth term. We can add those two terms together to get 2r squared pi over 4. Now let's take a look at the second and the fifth term. We can add those two together also to get 2 pi. We can cancel third and the sixth term since they're identical. And for the seventh term, we are going to expand its denominator and numerator with 2 in order to get that is 2 minus r squared pi over 4. Now, as you can see, we can easily cancel the first and the third term, and we will get that our red shaded area is equal to 2 pi, and that is approximately 6.28 squared units, and this is our solution. Alright, let's now try the method number 2, the simpler way of doing this task. In order to do this, we're going to again mark all our points as O, A and B as we did before. Now, let's notice that the point A is an arbitrary point. Why? Because it only depends upon the dimensions of this small half circle. So let's play around with it a little bit. So let's put the point A directly at the center of the line OB. And now let's construct our half circle and mark its center as C as before. Then from the point A, let's again construct our smaller quarter circle as before. Now if we mark the radius of our smaller half circle as R, that means that the radius of our quarter circle must be twice as that, so that is 2R. And it also means that the radius of our bigger quarter circle is equal to 4 times r, since that radius is twice as big as the radius of the smaller quarter circle. Now, for the better understanding, let's again mark all our circular segments as A1, A2 and A3. We can form the same equation as we did before. So, the red shaded area will be equal to the sum of areas of these two quarter circles minus the area of our half circle. Now, let's find these areas one by one. First, let's start with area number 1 of this small quarter circle. It will be equal to 1/4 of the quantity of 2r squared pi. We can simplify this, and if we cancel 4s, we will get that is r squared pi. Now let's take a look at the area 2 of this bigger quarter circle. This area is equal to 1/4 of the quantity of 4r squared pi. We can simplify this, and if we cancel 16 and 4, we will get the following result of 4r squared pi. Now our third area of the half circle is equal to 1/2 of the r squared pi, and we're just going to rewrite this one a little bit. Now we can take these three values and we can put them inside our first equation, and we will get the following, that our red area is equal to the sum of r squared pi plus 4r squared pi minus r squared pi over 2. We will expand first and the second term so that all our terms have the common denominator, and we will get that our red shaded area is equal to 9r squared pi over 2. Now, from our sketch, we can clearly see that the sum of the radius of the big and the small quarter circle must be equal to 4. So, therefore, 6r must be equal to 4. And that means that r must be equal to 4 over 6, which is equal to 2 over 3. Now we can plug this value back into our first equation and we will get the following. From here, we can just simplify things and then we can cancel both 9s and we will get that our area is equal to 4 pi over 2, and that means that our red shaded area is equal to 2 pi or approximately 6.28 squared units. So again, we got our solution. Now, let's do the method number 3, and this one is by far the simplest way of solving this problem, but it's the least fun way. Nevertheless, I'm going to show you. If we mark all our points as we did before, again, as before, we will notice that the point A is an arbitrary point. So that means that again we can play around with our sketch. Let's first make our sketch a little smaller for better understanding. Then, if we take our point A and slide it upward to the point B, so that those two points are the same, we are going to completely lose our half circle. And if we construct our quarter circle from the point A, you can clearly see that now we have one half of the full circle. And that is now equal to our red shaded area. So, that means that the red shaded area is equal to 1 half of the r squared pi. Since the diameter of this half circle is equal to 4, that means that the radius is equal to 2, so we can substitute that value in, and we will get that our area is equal to 1 half of the 2 squared pi, which is equal to 4 over 2 pi, and that means that our red shaded area is equal to 2 pi, or if you want to, it is approximately 6.28 squared units, and again, we have our solution. If you guys found another way to solve this problem, please write it down in the comment section below. And if you enjoyed this video, give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more content to come. And of course, until next time, as always, see you guys and take care.